Hello everyone, I shall now explain Prim's algorithm. For the given graph with 6 number of vertices and a number of edges. So let's understand the idea or the philosophy behind Prim's method. So at some instance of time, the two vertices are included into the spanning tree being built. So the Prim's method is to find the min cost spanning tree. We are in the process of building the minimum cost spanning tree. So at an instance, the two vertices B and C are included. So we now have to decide which must be the next vertex to be included into the spanning tree. The other vertices A, D, E and F are at a distance of 4, 6, 2, 9. When such is the case, at this point of time, I need to find out of the remaining vertices, which is that vertex which is closest, nearest to the vertices already in the spanning tree. So 4, 6, 2 and 9, very clear is that this is the nearest. So this E is probably attached to C. I get over here E. So this has been included. Now I'm left with the other one. So this A was nearer to BC with a distance of 4. Now having included E, is that more nearer? I should update. Similarly, D value, is that more nearer to E? If so, should this be updated? I do this for all the remaining vertices. Once I do that, the smallest or the nearest one will be included. This is to be done until every vertex is included into the spanning tree. Now with every vertex, we maintain two pieces of information. The first one is, to which vertex is that nearest to? Is that nearest to B? And by how much is that nearest to? So whenever I say nearest, it is only through an edge, not through a path. So I repeat, every vertex we keep track of two information. The first one, to which already included vertex is that nearest to? By how much is that nearest to? Yes, with all this, we are now ready to solve or apply Prim's for the graph. So every time we will be including one vertex along with an edge. To start with, we can start with any of the vertex arbitrarily. Let's say that I start with the vertex A. That is, vertex A is included into the spanning tree. So this is not nearest to anybody, doesn't have any cause, so that these values are dash dash. Now E is that the vertices adjacent to A are is that a B, a F and an E. So let me write that. So I should have this information B and is that for an F. So I'll have to write this, but the time being I shall record all the adjacent vertices, then start filling these values. So F and then is that an E. Now B. So it is nearest to the vertex A. By how much? It is at a cost of 3. Now similarly my F, it is nearest to A. With what? With a cost of 5. Similarly E, is that nearest to A? With what cost? 6. Now once I get all these values, I just have to pick up the one whichever has the shortest distance. 3, 5 and a 6. My obvious choice would be this. Just take this and put it over here on BA, 3. So 3 vertices, understand that these vertices are included into the spanning tree being built. And the remaining vertices are being given here. Now the vertex B is also included. I put a star indicating that they have been included. Now the vertex to be considered is B. Now I should find out all the vertices which are adjacent to the vertex B they here. So which are those? The vertex C is adjacent and F is adjacent. The E is already included, so I'll have to consider these two. So is that a C and then is that a F? Okay, now I go with the C. C, it is The next, it is nearest to the vertex B. At what distance? It is at a distance of 1. Now the F. So if we already had some value, right? It is nearer to A by 5. Now it's the B. So to B it is nearest by a value of 4. Now is 4 better than the previous? Yes, it is better. Only if it is better will we update this, or otherwise we retain the previous value. So F is nearer to B with what value? With a value of 4. Done. Now anything else? B is included here. F is brought over here. E, we just copy it as it is. So is that A, 6. We are done. Now once we are done with this listing, this updating the values, all I should do is pick the one whichever has the shortest value. 1, 4 and a 6. Obvious choice would be this. So I shall take this C, B, 1. Right, so what is it? C is included, so I'll put a star indicating that is included. Now once I have a newly included vertex, should I consider all its adjacent vertices? What is it? It is F I have, and I have this D. Okay, so I start with an F. So C, F is a distance of what? It's at a distance of 4. Now, what is my previous value? It is nearer to B with a value of 4. So, this also 4. It's a tie. So, you can resolve the tie either retaining the previous value or taking the reset value. I shall retain the previous value. The value would be B, 4. And the next one is D. So, D, we did not have an entry so far the first time. So, D nearer to C by what? It's at a distance of 6. I write it. It is connected to C by a distance of 6. Now, anything else? F we have written and the E is not written. I'll just copy it as it is. So, is that an A, 6. Now, of all this, I'll have to pick the one whichever has the smallest. 4, 6, 6. So this is the smallest. I just copy it as it is. So it is F, B, 4. So I shall have this star indicating that it is now been included. Now its adjacent vertices are D and E. So I'll take this D here. Now it is at a distance of 5. What was the previous value? Previous was 6. Certainly this is at a shorter length to F. So I shall update. D is nearer to F with a value of 5. Is the next one to be considered is E. So it's at a distance of 2. What was the previous value? It was nearer to A with a value of 6. 2 is better. So I shall update this. It is nearer to F with a value of 2. I'm done. No other vertices there here. Now of these two, 5 and 2, this is nearest. Will I include this? So it is E, F, 2. Now I am left with only D there here because all other things are done. Now D, this is the E. Will I put a star because it has already been now included there here? So D is at a distance of 8. Now the previous was, it was closer to F with a value of 5. 8 is greater than 5. So what I do is I shall retain the previous value. So it is F, 5. Now there are no options or choice. This is the only one to be selected here. I shall select this and I shall write it over here. F, 5, and I'm left with no other vertices. Every vertex is included. This completes my computation part. Now, which are the vertices? The edges, all the vertices are included. Which are the edges in my spanning tree? So I know. So B is nearer to A. That means that the edge AB is to be included. Now it is C and B. C and B to be included. What is this? It is F and B. Where is that? F and B to be included. Which is the next one? E and F. E and F to be included. Is the next one is a D and an F, right? So this, so now we see that it is all the vertices are connected with the minimum number of edges, and this forms the spanning tree. Now what is the cost of the spanning tree? This edges are given the cost here, or you can look it either way. It is the same thing. So the edges are, the cost of the edges, it is 3 plus 1 are 4, 4 plus 4 are 8, plus 2 are 10, plus 5 are 15 there here. The cost of this tree is 15. The same value we obtained when we applied Kruskal's algorithm back for the same graph here. So this is how Prim's algorithm can be applied for the given problem. So just have to have this tabulation day here, and then with little marking and being cautious, you would be able to complete this with almost minimum time and also with a correct value. Thank you.